Hey everyone, today I'm going to be decluttering some eyeshadow palettes. Obviously, I have a lot of eyeshadow palettes, so I decided it was time to do another declutter video. I will be doing an eyeshadow palette collection video soon, but for now, if you want to see me declutter some eyeshadow palettes, just keep watching.
I'm decluttering the Morphe Pride palette from like a year ago. It is stunning. It has so many beautiful shades, but again, it's just not a palette that I've reached for. I haven't even swatched this. I haven't used this. Like, there are so many beautiful tones, but I have them in other palettes, and since this was limited edition, I'm just not gonna get use out of it. So I'd much rather, you know, give this to a friend and declutter it. I did buy this with my own money. I will state otherwise, but like, if I did buy something, or like if a brand sent me in, I'll let you guys know, but I did buy this with my own money. It is stunning and I love the cause. I just have these shades elsewhere, so I don't think I need this palette. It's one of those palettes though where I'm like, it's beautiful, and the more I look at it, I'm like, maybe I should keep it, but for now, this is a declutter. Next, I am decluttering the Morphe 18B palette. This is a beautiful palette. Like, you have a half with just like a more like warmer palette, and then you have blue tones and green tones. This palette is stunning, but I know that my makeup friend is going to enjoy this palette way more than I am. I haven't even used it. I literally just swatched it the other day, so I'm happy to declutter this to her. It's a stunning palette, and honestly, like, if I didn't need to declutter some palettes, I'd keep it, but I know that it'll go to someone who loves makeup like I do. I am decluttering the Behind the Screen palette by Killer Queens Cosmetics. I did buy this myself. I do have an affiliate code with them, but I bought this myself. I'm decluttering this simply because I really don't need it, and I have a friend who I know will love all these tones. I just have way too many palettes and I need to declutter some, and this unfortunately is one of the ones I'm decluttering. It is a stunning palette and the quality is amazing. It's just I have these colors in other palettes, and plus, I mean, when I know that the palette can get decluttered to someone who will get good use out of it, I'm always down for that. Next, I'm decluttering the Riviera ABH palette. This palette is stunning and it's such a good summer palette, but honestly, as much as I love this palette, I don't reach for it. I have the bright shades in other palettes, so it's really just not a palette that I need to keep in my collection. I've kind of been holding on to it because of the few unique shades, and even with the unique shades, I have them in other palettes most likely, so I decided to declutter this one. Next, I'm going to be decluttering this beautiful Something Gorgeous palette by Love Luxe Beauty. I love this palette. I haven't used it on my eyes, but I really, really love their formula. It's just not a palette I need. I just don't need all these purple and like peachy tones. I have them in other palettes. Literally, the only reason I've been keeping this is for the middle shade, but I decided I'm going to declutter it since I don't use it. I'm also going to be decluttering the original Norvina palette with ABH. It's just not a palette that I've reached for since I bought it. Like, I think I've literally used this once. It's just not a palette I need, so I am decluttering it. It's gorgeous, and I do really like the ABH formula, but I just have other palettes that I prefer, and I have so many purple tones that I can't justify keeping this. I'm going to be decluttering the Morphe X James Charles mini palette. I got this on a whim. I was like, oh, maybe I'll use it. I haven't used it. If I want to do a neutral look, I have neutral palettes. And if I want to do bright looks, like I always do, I have bright palettes. Like, I just do not need this palette. It's not a palette that I reach for. I don't need it in my life. And I mean, I do love Morphe palettes and their formula. This is just not a palette that I will reach for. If you're curious what nail polish I'm wearing Holo Taco Menchi. That is what I'm wearing on my thumb. Beautiful nail polish. Definitely would recommend Holo Taco always. The next palette that I'm decluttering is the Huda Beauty Amethyst Obsessions palette. I've had this palette for a while and I've literally used it once. I love purple tones, which is why I've been keeping it, but honestly, it's just not something that I use or that I really need in my life. Like I said, it is a very gorgeous palette. The packaging is gorgeous. I love the Huda Beauty formula. It's just not like my color story very much. Like, it has purple tones, but they're kind of like more so purples that I don't really reach for. It's a very stunning palette, just not for me.
Next, I'm decluttering the Cremated palette by Jeffree Star. I got this palette way before the whole, you know, drama happened. But drama aside, this is just not a palette that I need. It's just too many tones of gray for me. Like, I just don't need it. I have a lot of other palettes that I can use, so I'll be sticking with those. I'm decluttering the Lime Crime Venus XL2. It's just not a palette that I need. It's a beautiful, like, natural looking palette if you're into that vibe, but if you know me, I am a bright eyeshadow girl. Like, I do not do natural looks ever, basically, just because I like bright colors. So personally, this isn't the palette for me, but it is still very gorgeous, just not for me. Next, I'm decluttering this Run Wild palette by BH Cosmetics. It's stunning. You get blushes and you get an eyeshadow palette and two highlighters. It's a stunning palette, but I just got it on a whim before I got a ton of highlighters. Blushes, and I have enough blushes now that I did not need this palette, nor do I need the eyeshadow shades because I have them in other palettes. But honestly, the BH formula has really been great lately, so I'm very excited to see what other eyeshadow palettes they come out with. You guys know I love their Sweet Shop palettes, so really hoping to see them come out with more fun palettes. But this palette is very versatile, it's just not for me. I'm decluttering the Killer Purr palette by Menagerie Cosmetics. This palette is a stunning neutral palette, well, not neutral, but like a natural palette, and don't ask me why I bought this. I bought it because it was beautiful, and I was like, you know, maybe I'll use this. Like, maybe I'll do natural looks with this. Let's be honest. No, I did not. I used it once, and that was it. It was stunning, but it's just not a palette that I need or that I'll reach for, unfortunately. I'm decluttering the Mini Controversy palette by J-Star and, you know, Shane Dawson. I can't bring myself to use it up, even though I already bought it, so I'm decluttering it. I don't need it in my life. It's beautiful, but I just don't need it, and I do not gravitate towards any of my J-Star palettes anymore, which sucks, but it is what it is. Thank you guys so much for watching this declutter video. If you enjoyed, make sure you subscribe, comment down below any videos you'd like to see me do, go follow my Instagram, Makeup by Tasha XO, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.
You're a good boy. It's okay. It was just a firework. I've never seen boy. Like, I'll get you. You got black eyes. Simon, you go get him.
Hey.
Not for you.
Oh, thank you. You're gonna get my phone all snotty.
You get my phone all snotty. That's not for you, no.
Good guy, huh?
You're doing all the way over there, huh? Huh? You're doing all the way over there. Hi.
Oh.
You're a sweetie pie today, huh?
No, don't touch my toes.
Did you say no, don't touch my toesies?
Aw, you're kneading. That's so cute.
Hi.